Hello to everyone. In this video I'm going to make a useful adaptation for my old car which I really missed last winter in severe frost. As you understand from the title, it will be a diesel fuel heater. I had no problems with starting the engine, even at minus 20. However, at this temperature there was a risk of stalling in transit. Fuel in the filter and the fuel wire thickened, the speed fell, and it was only by a miracle that I got to the place. I decided to make this simple adaptation which once and for all, sincerely hope, will save me from these problems. The device will be a heat exchanger integrated in the engine cooling system, and it will be performed on the principle of a pipe in a pipe, so as not to overheat the fuel in. It will be an autonomous system. Running engine is heated by fuel. So I took two suitable pipes, the main thing so that one would enter the other and there would be a gap of a few millimeters between them. It is there that the fuel will be circulated, taking heat through the wall of the inner tube, which in turn will pass the antifreeze. Since I use metal tubes, it is desirable to clean them so that debris and rust do not get into working fluids. Well, then I decided to use a lathe to miter the adapters for nipples, although it would be possible to weld ordinary washers and tubes of the desired diameter. But of course with the machine everything will be more accurate. After I collected all the parts together and connected them, I decided to weld the fuel inlet and outlet pipes at such an angle that it would resemble a cochlea, so that the fuel at the entrance slides between the walls of the tubes. Probably due to such a given angle, it will move around the inner tube in a spiral, but this is inaccurate. After welding, I decided to clean all the seams, and after I checked everything for leaks, I decided to paint this. Next was the installation of a heat exchanger on the car, and to my surprise it took no more than 20 minutes. So as not to drain the antifreeze from the engine system, I squeezed the nipples with clamps. The installation location was determined in advance. This was the return connection of the passenger compartment heater. The output of the heated fuel is immediately directed to the fuel filter. Since in the warm season of the year, heating the fuel to nothing and overheating worsens its lubricating properties. With this arrangement it can be easily disconnected, just by moving the stove to a cold position. So in the end it turned out to be an autonomous device with summer-winter switching without any relay wires and timers. I think many noticed how hard diesel engines work in the cold season. So here after the installation of the heater the engine began to work much softer. The fuel filter is slightly warm to the touch, but I think this will be quite enough. I have not yet been able to conduct accurate measurements of all temperatures, but if you are interested I necessarily have them. I'll do when I wait really strong frosts. While waiting for your comments and considerations about this device. If the video like to share it with friends. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell to skip the new videos. See you very soon.